Okay, guys. What would you do if you just found out your child had high traces of lead in their body and could lead to life-changing consequences? Us, as millennials, would turn to the internet. And as you can see here, I went to the Vandenberg County Health Department's website and typed in lead in the search bar. And as you can see, it took me to a dead end. I'm Dream Killer. This is Caitlin, and this is Home. Homebody. And now it's walking me through that. There we go. Okay. So, after seeing this, this is why we are here today, to raise awareness and education on lead in the Evansville area. The issues we are wanting to focus on are lead awareness, making the Vandenberg County website a click-friendly website, and also making it a one-stop shop. And Caitlin is going to tell you how we're going to do this.
Thank you, Dream Killer. So, as she shared, the Vandenberg County Health Department does have a hyperlink that does not lead you to the information, but yet, the Vandenberg County Health Department does have a vast amount of good resources on their page. We want to take your resources that you have shared with the community and enhance on that. So we want to come up with an innovative idea to enhance your website. And I'm going to share with you the four key metrics that we are going to focus on to enhance your website. So the four key metrics, it first starts out with appearance. So all websites have to have that eye-appealing graphics, text, and overall appearance to grab the visitor right when they get onto the website, because that's the first thing that they visually see. Next is the content. So we want to focus on three main areas of context. And these are going to be drop-down boxes for these three main areas. And that's going to be the source, the solution, and also the resources. So, and in the resources, that's where you'll find the products and the vendors. Next, we want to focus on the functionality, such as the hyperlink, which is easily fixable, but we want to make sure that we get in there and frequently make sure that everything's functioning properly. And with this as well, we want to make sure it's very click friendly, because a lot of the visitors know what they want to come and what kind of information they want to get into when they reach the website, and we want to make sure it's very click friendly on to be accessible for that information. And lastly, fourth is the usability. So we are going to team up with USI's CIS department, and they can track the usability of the website and see what areas of the website are getting that eye attraction to, such as like the three sources that I said, the solution area, the products, and also the products. So now I'm going to transfer it to Homebody, and he is going to continue discussing the content area of our website.
Thank you, Caitlin. And as she briefly mentioned, it's going to start with the family determining where the source is. You know, deteriorating pipes put lead in the soil, it also puts lead in the water, and chipping paint puts lead in the soil and off the side of the house. So then the family can decide financially if they can solve that problem short term or long term. And if they cannot solve it long term, then they'll look at the products presented by other groups that they can do solutions for themselves, what they can do at that current moment to reduce the lead in their child's blood from the source.
And then it'll also provide drop-down menus where all this can be accessed from the front page and they don't have to search for it. It requires less clicks to get to where they want to go. And lastly, it'll have vendors and contractors on there. Our solution strategy, it involves the key partners of the Vandenberg County Health Department and the CIS students. And what they'll be doing is they'll be first having a discussion on what they would like to change and what they would like to keep on the website. And this will be an ongoing discussion. It's not just a one-time thing. They will then decide on what they are keeping, what they're changing. Then beta testing will begin in the spring. This will allow whoever wants to test it, they can look for errors throughout the website. They can see how many clicks it takes. And this will better determine key metrics of the website on where areas can be improved and what needs to remain the same. And this will allow the Vandenberg County Health Department to better understand their visitors. So the value that we create is this is essentially a free idea where it's using student labor to help the Vandenberg County Health Department increase the lead awareness in the community. And I'm going to pass it to Dream Killer, and she's going to wrap things up for us.
So in conclusion, we have virtually showed you the Vandenberg County Health Department's website and with the improvements that we can make in the appearance and content, functionality, and in the usability. And with these positive changes, we can better the community here in Vandenberg County. Thank you for your guys' time today.
Thank you guys. Good job.
Sorry about our video not working.
Oh, that's okay.